Good day to one and all. This is Dr. Sivaraman of iknowindices.com. Let me give the link for the live market quote page and also focus the camera over that of the live market quote page and show you where exactly the market is now before we commence the tracking process. So currently euro is trading around 1.4835, 1.4837. 1.4804 is the low, which is intact, whereas during that of the European session, we saw that 1.4868, they formed and subsequently made a brief upward stop and around 12 GMT. I told you late session they handled and they went up to 48.77 and then started making the slide around 13 GMT towards close of European session, and then also they are trying to make for the downward during the early US session. Similarly, in the case of GBP, they went up from that of 1.6667 to 8.2 and then 8.9, brief upward stop, and they carefully done it and dropped it. Now you come across a negative net change. In the case of euro, only 16 pips positive net change right from that of the Japanese session, from that of the yesterday's close. So you can understand they are simply holding at the higher level and distributing the positions to that of the traders who find that the market might be bullish and it might rise further up, so they go in a hurry for short covering. Then in the case of the denominator currencies, they made the quick drop in the case of USD CHF to 86.45, below that of the psychological level 86.50, and started gaining the levels. And still, euro is showing only 20 pips positive net change, whereas CHF is showing still about 68 pips negative net change. So they are handling the CHF crosses on the downside, and then subsequently they will accumulate them and then gain the levels. Similarly, in the case of USD Yen, during that of the European session, we have seen that it is in a subdued move and with a range of 24 pips, and subsequently they made a quick downward move to that of 81.13. And then gone up, and they have gone above that of the initial low, and now you come across only 7 pips negative net change. Still, you come across USD gaining move, but in a very, very nominal way, as far as euro, GBP and USD loosening move with regard to these three majors. And also in the case of USD CHF, USD weakening move is shown. But when you look into that of the commodity pairs, Canadian dollar is just trading around 95.40, 95.44. 94.84 has become the new low, and then subsequently they started gaining and went up above that of the initial high, 95.48. 34 pips positive net change is seen, and Australian dollar is also showing about 8 pips positive net change, and they came down to 1.0905 and then subsequently went up to 1.0963 after breaching that 45 area and about 20 pips upward stop, and then started making that drop. So you come across in the majors the USD weakening move, but the commodity pairs are showing the contrarian move to start with, and subsequently they are expected to make slowly the USD gaining and the USD weakening moves for the weekend, so that either way they will try to hit the stops of the traders and try to earn out of that. But primarily the players are holding high and building sell positions, and those who are nervous, they come for the short covering here. So let me go back to that of the PowerPoint presentation. So I have taken part 1 by 9 GMT. So 9 to 9.45 GMT, and taken some positions also. And today I explained how exactly the chart could be used in order to note down the initial lows and the highs which are set in the market. I'll again repeat it for the benefit of those who have joined fresh, and also with regard to that of the live market quote page, what happened to the highs and then what happened to our trades, I'll explain. With regard to the highs, euro and GBP, we have seen that they made the extended rise for about 2 hours, and towards close of that, they made a brief cut of the high and then started dropping. And also in the case of GBP, so we can understand the mid-session they handled the crosses, and the late session and the early session they handled the majors. We are able to visibly see that during that time. And also I'll just focus now the trade what I have taken or committed during that of the European session. So I have not taken because it is 9 GMT and the session starts by about 7:30 GMT. So obviously there was not much of an opportunity in the case of Euro and GBP to do a buy and sell or a sell and buy trade. I was explaining that during the late session they will gain and we could easily take a sell position, but since you are not available along with me, so I do not want to commit any position and show that I have booked a profit. So I want to take the trading decisions before you so that you will be able to see how exactly the trading decisions are to be made without any sentimental attachment to any currency pair. Now, with regard to the positions what I have taken, only the commodity pairs, they are not done the stop and when Euro and GBP are rising. So I initiated a sell position at 1.0918 with a stop of 30 pips. So the stop was at 1.0948. It got stopped out and subsequently went up to 1.0963. And afterwards it was not rising it for 10 minutes. So I reinstated the sell position with 30 pips stop. I was able to read that the first go they made a quick run and subsequently they have not cut the high and we can also see it in the chart. So that shows that they have done only a stop and after an extended move because being the last day and I took a sell position and kept 30 pips stop and then subsequently you know that still, I have not closed the position. I am expecting further drop in the case of Australian dollar. During that time, during the US session, I wanted to close it. Normally, I close it within the session because the subdued moves are seen. I wanted to just keep stop at entry now and remove the earlier stop. So that we don't lose anything and now already it is trading below that of the 30 pips level. So if I close it, I'll have a break even. And if they make a small dip, then probably I'll be able to catch up some net profit because I lost about 30 pips in that of the upward move. And in the case of Canadian dollar, I took a buy position at 0.9507 and they made a brief downward stop and I kept 30 pips below that stop. But they are not filled at the stop. They came down to 94.84 and that was around that of 11:30 GMT and then subsequently the stop was around 94.77. They came up to 94.84 and then started gaining the levels. So now we can keep stop at entry, take profit by trailing the stop and when they gain and go above that of the initial high and further up, then probably I'll try to book profit. As in the first 30 minutes of the US session, they have not cut the low or the high in any of the pairs. So they were expected to swing and slide. This is the market reading. So whenever they start the session and if they just breach the high or the low within 30 minutes of the session, then they are expected to make an extended move. But if they fail to cut the high or the low, that means they wanted to continue the trend on the downside. But before that, they will just make small swing without breaching the high so that the traders will commit some positions with a bullish feel and then they start dropping it. Because the spread between the high and the low indicate in most of the pairs that they are only making a subdued move and mainly holding high to slide. With regard to the cross, what I had taken during that of the European session, the sell position was taken around 0.98918, in the case of Euro GBP, and still they are around the same level, they have not made any sort of drop or rise, so still the stop is there at 50 pips above. In Euro CHF, I took a buy position around 28.91, and that was the low at that time, then subsequently they formed for the low because of CHF drop and it came down to 28.51 and I kept 50 pips stop and it is not being filled So I will try to keep stopped entry and continue the trade during that of the year session. So these are all the only positions I committed, and then subsequently wanted to take the positions during that of the year session. Before that, let me explain to you the session timings, what your the players follow, so that you will be able to focus more on the timings rather than that of the levels. Then you will be able to read the market much in a much better way. Then European session, the Japanese session is from 0030 to 7 GMT. 7 to 7:30 GMT is a gap time between the Japanese and the European session. They try to make false moves during that time. And US session, European session is from 7:30 to 13 GMT. 13 to 13:30 GMT is the gap time. Then US session is from 13:30 GMT to 20:30 GMT. So we started our webinar by 14 GMT. So you can understand 30 minutes past of the European session, US session, and they are expected to make the swing moves to start with as it appears, because in first 30 minutes they are not breached the high or the low in any of the currency pair. So these are all the session timings followed by that of the players during the early session, that is 1.5 hours from the start of the session. Then 1.5 hours towards close of the session, they will be handling the majors, and the mid session they will be handling the crosses. That you have to keep it in mind, so that you will be able to easily choose the right currency pair to take position and try to close it. So track the market using the GMT time frame rather than your local time, so that you will be able to be participative in 24 hours market without any difficulty. Then every session you come across the early session, then mid session and the late session, and also the gap time between the sessions. Those timings you should be familiar with, I have just shown it. And I use only the live market code page for tracking the market, and many people said that why not you use the charts and things like that. So I thought that I can show you this chart, and in the event you are not able to make a note of the initial lows and the highs which are set between 2:30 and 3:30 GMT during the Japanese session, you can take it from that of the chart, and also just understand the trend in a short time frame in that particular session, so that you will be able to take appropriate positions. Then make a note of the high and the low and the net change very frequently in the, from the market, so that you will be able to understand how far they have made the moves. So whether it is a big spike like 150 pips net change levels, etc., or only about 20-30 pips, now you come across zero is just firming up, JBB is also firming up, and they are only making about 40 pips net change still. No, you find that they are only just firming up in order to attract the traders to come in, and then later on they will try to give it to them. This they do it by circular trades. So when all are watching, you will find that market is making the swings, and this is nothing but the contributions from the other players. Then how to take an entry decision? When the market is near the high, you can try to take a sell position when the high is not been breached for more than 30 minutes from the start of the session. And in case in 30 minutes time frame if they breach, then we have to wait for them to settle it till, I mean, for 2 hours. That is an extended move. And during the European session, I explained to you that they breached and they showed the extended move upward. I asked you to wait for 2 hours before taking further positions in the market. That is why I have not taken the positions in Euro and GBP as a sell position. At that time of our discussion, Euro was around 48.63 and GBP was around 1.6678. And then they made a brief upward stop, and that upward stop you could have used to take the sell positions after 2 hours. So avoid taking the positions when the market is in the middle level. And today I have taken a buy position, I mean sell position in the case of Australian dollar when it was in the middle level, you know that I was stopped out. So when the market is in the middle level, if you try to take a position, then you'll find that you might be stopped out in case if they make an upward stop and or go up to that of the high as a false move before making a draw. But I just committed, just to explain to you that we can also trade in case if they stop us out, we can re-enter again at a higher level. They will show a better level for us to enter, and that position should be able to give you the profit. So that is why I just taken the position there. And similarly, in the case of Canadian dollar. I took a position near that of the low, but subsequently they made a brief dip or a stop and below that, because I was taking in the middle session, and subsequently they are not filled the stop and gone up, so there was a possibility to book profit in that or keep stop at entry in those positions. So this is how the entries are to be decided during the start of the session. If they are closer to the high, we can take a sell position. If they are not breached the high for more than 30 minutes, or we can take a buy position if the low has not been breached for more than 30 minutes from the start of the session. So by 14:17 now, the GMT time, still they are not breached the high in the case of euro and GBP, not breached the low in the case of USD CHF and USD CAD. So you find that there is a great opportunity to enter into the leather market. Now, once you take an entry, you should plan also the exit. Suppose I take a sell position near that of the high, set, then obviously I have to think about keeping a limit order near that of the low. And the limit order, I can move away from that of the market when the going is good. But the stop, I should not remove or move it away when the market comes closer to that. It's better to accept the loss and review the market for 30 minutes to 1 hour and then re-enter into the market when they are not making further continuation of the move. So on that basis, I took another sell position in the case of Australian dollar, and now I kept stop at the entry then. So once the position makes profit of 20-25 pips, you try to keep stop at entry and remove the order, remove the stop order. That I have done it in the case of Australian dollar and Canadian dollar. I just showed it to you. Then afterwards, when they try to move it, you see whether they are filling the limit. And in case if they are not filling the limit quickly, then trail the stop, maintaining 15 pips from that of the market, and try to take a minimal profit or simply close the position if you want. So the entry and exit decisions are very, very important. And when the profit is shown, you try to grab it, and you can always participate in the market again if they continue that. You need not feel disappointed, and you need not feel that you have closed it in a hurry and then subsequently they made further drop. You can always close it around a determined level, and in case that particular buy level is not making profit for 30 minutes, you can re-enter, sell again at a lower level as a technical trade and continue capturing the profit during that of for the downward move. So when they breach the low or the high, then you have to identify whether they are trying to do a stop and or a false move or an extended move or an intentional move. Extended move, the stop and is for 30 minutes and they just go above that of the high and come down below that of the initial high. False move is they go up to that of the high and come down and go and breach the low and go below and make an extended move. See, they can just breach the high and go above and stay there for more than 30 minutes and continue the rise for 2 hours and then reverse. That is extended move. In case beyond 2 hours, if they continue to rise, then it becomes an intentional move. And once they make an intentional move, then you can only do a technical trade of buy above that of the high and try to book profit during that time. And in case if they make an extended stop, and that they do it during that of the trend reversal time, whenever the volume increases in the market, especially during trend reversal time, like the month end and the month beginning time, they'll try to do the such extended stop, and then in case if they do an extended stop, and it is very similar to the stop, and the time frame might be about 30 minutes to 1 hour, but they will gain the level of about 150 pips in the case of euro and 250 pips in the case of GBP, like a very big upward spike, and within no minutes they will start dropping it and stop cutting the high for 10 minutes, and within 30 minutes you will find where the market was earlier trading. So that sort of move is referred as extended stop, and once they make an extended stop and on the upside, then you will find the continuation of the downward move, and that you can see only during that of the month end and month beginning time, so not during the rest of the time. And probably you come across during such time some of the prime data like FOMC rates and also non-farm payrolls, etc., are being released, and they are being used as the trigger factor for that. Then I explained the technical trade. So coming to that of the expected market moves for today, the Iran JPY are expected to make swing and form of moves for the weekend at a later part. So they are expected to drop, they have made the drop, and then subsequently they are expected to gain the levels a little bit towards close. Why they do it? Still, they are not done the rise. They wanted to make the drop first. And why they wanted to drop? So what they do is normally they quickly sell at the higher level and for the weekend, and then try to drop the market and hold it for the next session at a lower level. Then those who are holding that long positions from there at the lower level for weekend, they will try to book profit. And in that process, you'll find some of the traders will try to take sell positions in order to capture further profit during the downward move. And the players try to gain the levels. When the traders started selling, they try to gain the levels and induce them to do the short covering and then afterwards make further slide. So this is how they trap the traders on either side. If you are holding a long position, they will try to hit your stop at the lower level. And if you are holding short position, they will just go above and induce your stop to be triggered. So either way stops, they try to do it on Friday, the weekend. So what you have to do is, in case if they do the stop and on the downside first and you try to buy, then in case if they do an upward stop and on the upper side, try to book profit and take a sell position, because the trend is down now, but they will try to discourage traders selling. So you would have noticed in the case of Euro and GBP, when they are at the bottom, like 1.27 in the case of, or 1.30 for that matter recently, and also in the case of GBP around below that of 1.60 and things like that, they just discourage the traders to take any buy position. If you buy and they may only just show 10 to 15 pips profit, afterwards if you just wait, they will drop it. That sort of moves, they have been doing it, and subsequently they accumulated all the buy positions from when the traders were selling in distress and then gained all the levels now, and they are booking profit and try to build the sell positions. So this is how they do the trade with about 1000 to 1500 pips swing in a month. And why they are doing it like that? So that on an average they will be getting about 100 to 150 pips in their several millions of positions. Now, before going to that of the trade, let me show the other PowerPoint presentation, how exactly the initial lows and the highs are to be noted down. So this is how around 2:30 to 3:30 GMT, the initial lows and the highs are to be noted down in case we are able to watch the early Japanese session. And in case if you are not able to watch it, then you can try to take it from that of the chart. So Euro formed the initial high of 1.4846 and now it is trading slightly above but still below that of 1.4877. So this sort of pullbacks you can try to sell and they will be able to show profit. They are doing only a higher level consolidation to slide. Then in the case of GBP, 1.6626 was a low and they breached the low by one pip and then gained it. And the high was 1.6663 and then they went up to 1.6689 and then made the drop all the way down and hit by one pip and again they are firmed up. This is how they are making the swings in GBP in order to create the market sentiments. So GBP is the currency which is being used almost most of the time to create the market sentiment. So you have to be carefully read their hidden agenda. And before making the rise, you know that GBP was looking so weak and everybody was telling Euro has gone up so much. Why GBP is not going? It is very frequently going below 1.60. Do you think still GBP can rise? So if you understand their methodology of trapping the traders, then you will be the winner in the market. So they have been doing it and accumulating GBP positions and then gain the levels. Now they are happily booking profit. So this is how we should be able to read the overall picture of the market. Then you will be able to really do fearless trades. Then USDCHF, they breached the low, the high is intact, and the low they breached it, 87.28, and then came below that of 87 and went up to 86.50 and then made one more downward stop into 86.45, and then they are just slowly holding, still holding below that of 87.28. So only if they catch up, we'll come across the further quick gains to that of 48 and above can have today. So a lot of traders might be holding long positions in USDCHF, so they are just testing the patience to liquidate the longs before their rise towards close and also on Monday onwards. Then in the case of yen, 81.41.49 was the initial low. They quickly made about 30 to 35 pips downward stop, and 81.13 has become the low and went up to that of 81.47. You would have just noticed during the early European session, US session, and then they have come down to 81.34. So a lot of traders might have taken the buy position when USD yen has gone to 85 area. So they are expecting them to liquidate the long positions before making further rise. So this is how they trap the traders. So it is not the question of the strength and weakness of any country or a currency. It's predominantly the earning process of the players. An Australian dollar, 1.0883 is the low. It is intact, 1.0940 is the high. And they went up to 1.0963 and then they are hovering around that of the initial high above that. So they are just holding it still. They are not breached with a high. So they are not expected to go up. So by the time I've been talking, they have dropped about 10 to 15 pips in all the currencies. Then in the case of Canadian dollar, 95.03 was the low and they came down to 94.84 and then went up 95.19, 95.23 are the current levels, 95.27 was the high. They breached the high and formed 95.48 and then now they are just holding around below that of this as a consolidation to gain, because now they are handling the crosses. As you see, the net changes in the case of USD CAD and Australian dollar, both are showing positive net change, nominal positive net change. In all the currencies excepting USDCHF, you find subdued moves about 20-30 pips, less than that. You can understand they are only doing the consolidation. So this, you can do it with the help of the initial lows and the highs and understanding. And every day if you make a note of it, you'll be able to understand what they are trying to do it in the market and whom they are trying to trap. They are not trapping on one side. They trap on either side. Keep that in mind. So it is not that if you are bullish and try to do a buy and sell trade, you are clever. It is not at all like that. And the players can easily trap either way on a daily basis. Then let me minimize this particular PowerPoint presentation and show you the chart and focus the camera over there. Okay. Now you find that Finbase.com has got a consolidated levels here. And this will give you a better understanding, very similar to that of the live market quote page, but slightly delayed. You come across the highs and the lows are being displayed, and also the levels are indicated, and it gets refreshed once in a minute. And you find once you take the mouse over it, the chart is being displayed, and you can understand when they have done that upward stop and or a downward stop, and so that you'll be able to easily understand whether you can enter into that market or not. So if they finish the upward stop and then you can take a sell position. They will not do upward stop and very frequently, only once in a session, or they just do a firming up move once if they fail to cut the high in first 30 minutes. So during such upward move, you can try to take a sell. In the case of GBP, they went zero, they went up to 48.65 and then if they have taken a sell, then they made a dip. Similarly, in the case of GBP, 66.73 they showed and then made a small dip now. So you find that they are just slowly making a dip. And if you take a 5-minute chart here, you are able to understand. So if you take the 5-minute chart, if you just click that particular currency, you find the chart is being displayed how frequently they have done the downward stop and the upward stop, and you may say that it is head and shoulder formation, all those things. But if you try to understand that they are making only from that of 1.6690 to 1.6630. just a matter of 60 pips. But in that, if you see the red candles, you might become afraid, or the green candle, you might become bullish. But try to always relate it to that of the levels what you come across, because it's a 5-minute chart. And if you move the chart here, the moving is not allowed. So if you try to take the 1-hour chart, then you will find the spread will gradually increase, because the market has made such a big move on the upside and the downside. Probably if you go for the longer time frame, you will be able to see the trend. Invariably, we tend to connect the highs and the lows and try to find out what is the channel formation, etc. But you know very well, the market does not travel in linear fashion. It will make up and down move. You can find that in a chart or a channel by connecting all the lines, that it has made that upward move and go up to that of the resistance, go up to that of the support and things like that. When they breach it, we don't have an answer for it. Then again, connect all the highs and the lows in the next peak to the bottom, and we can continue to talk. But this, we try to miss it. So there comes the biggest problem with regard to the charts. Hence, I try to give that importance to that of the live market put page, so that you will be able to easily understand on a given day. It is April 29th. From here, right from that of the Japanese session, they are only doing the consolidation. If you see the 5-minute chart, you find that the consolidation from the early hours is just a matter of about 40-50 pips. And in that, if you try to enter into that, maximum you will be able to earn about 30 to 40 pips, because at the bottommost level people will be afraid to buy, at the topmost level people will be afraid to sell. This is the normal condition or mindset of the traders. The players know very well the psychology and the limitations of the traders and try to exploit it. In such a situation, when the players are not respecting the support or resistance of the support, there is a question of just following it and try to keep the stop below that the support, or try to keep the stop above of the resistance, because they just make that spikes above that and try to hit and afterwards make the drop. So even though you have just kept that stop above that of the resistance, and the, you either the market or the platform providers can extend it little more and hit your stop and then subsequently drop. If you keep a sell order here, they will not feel it. If you keep a buy order, they will definitely feel it. That is a scenario we come across as a limitations with regard to trading. So you have to keep all those things in mind, how the players are creating the market sentiment and act against it of the traders, and also how the platform providers provide the constraints to that of the traders, like avoid giving the hedging facility and charging overnight interest, even though there is no other overnight interest from that of the bank. The platform providers are gaining out of that, and the liquidity providers share it to a certain extent. So you find that there are a lot of things which are untold to that of the traders. So invariably the traders think that this is the way the system works, but there are other aspects pertaining to that. That also you need to understand. You have to understand the limitations of the banks and also the players. They cannot make 500 pips or 600 pips drop or the rise in a single day, excepting when there is an euphoric condition in the market. Otherwise, they make only about 150 pips rise in the case of euro and 250 pips rise in the case of GBP or a drop. So that is how they have the limitations. If you understand all those things, I explained it in my trading system webinar series, then you will be able to understand the whole picture of the market and try to trade wisely. So you can try to take the different time frames and see how exactly the market has made the performance. But that is of an academic interest. What is more important is a 5-minute chart and see when exactly they had done the stop and can I enter a sell here. So they have made the stop and then afterwards for nearly about 2 hours they have not done almost the upward stop, and so I can take a sell and keep a stop above this. This is how you can do it. The second important thing with regard to the chart, so you know that the start of the day is April 29th here. Then around 2 a.m. and 3:30, what is the high? They formed it between 2:30 and 3:30. You can make a note of it. Might be slightly different from that of the live market quote page, noting down, because they are actual numbers. Here you come across some averaging because of the 5 minutes on what are the trades done during that particular 5 minutes. It will average and give that point. So you will find a slight variations in this. Still, you can make a note of it. Okay, they breached the high. Afterwards, they are hovering around that of the high. So anybody has taken the buy position near the high, they have been given only one or two times the profit booking. How much profit? About 15 to 17 pips. So what they are trying to do it, they are inducing the traders to buy, but they are not giving profit booking opportunity. What is the meaning of it? They are sellers. So once they sell, and if they avoid the traders taking the sell positions by making an upward stop, and they started making the slow slide, so that anybody has taken the buy position will slowly see that the position is making loss, and later on they will find that the moves become very quick from that of Monday or towards close of the US session. Then they will rip, and next day probably people will think that, okay, earlier I had taken a buy at 1.42, 1.44, I just waited, I was able to book profit, why not at 1.48? And the turnaround is not being indicated. Probably you can say that head and shoulder formation is seen, so there could be a trend reversal and things like that. But if you see the head and shoulder formation here, they have made a rise. So conveniently we can say head and shoulder formation is seen and things like that. But earlier also you come across such things, afterwards they have made the gains. So ultimately what is more important is the live quote and the live action in the market, and that price action is going to give you the insight for you to take trading decisions. So why I am telling is, you can use the chart, there is no harm, as long as you are willing to note down only the levels and things like that. If you do an extensive study in the chart, you will invariably get more confusions, because one study might give a profit in a given time, and subsequently if you apply the same study, it might give a loss or hit the stop. Then you look for another study, then you go in for a confirmations of such studies and continue to do that technical analysis. By the time market is not going to wait, and sometimes you might find that the market is making quick moves at time, you will be able to enter into that market, but like a consolidation. But if they are making quick moves, by the time you finish your study and look into the market has already gone up. And you know that I was explaining to you that near out of the high you can sell and things like that. Now I don't find opportunity. Just I was talking for about 10-15 minutes and the market has moved away. So this is how we miss when you focus more on this study. That is why what I suggest is, these studies are all meant for the technical analysts. Okay, let them do it. And let them give this straight away, okay, we can do a buy and sell trade or a sell and buy trade, and what could be the level wherein you can sell or what could be the level you can buy, and that will be really helpful for the small traders. So I am trying to focus on that particular aspect. So using the live market quote page, instead of giving the levels, what I suggest or what I explain is the type of moves to be followed, so that whatever I explain, if you are stopped out once or twice, then you fail to accept it as a concept. Then for you to develop the mental strength, it will take a longer time. But if you learn to that particular process, like learning a driving, and you drive at ease on your own, and afterwards you don't require my help. So I want you people to learn that way in this market. So that is why I have not been showing the chart. It's not that I don't know, because I am basically an applied statistics professor. I have done extensively all these studies, and finally I found that there are a lot of limitations with regard to that. But explaining all those limitations and bringing in a controversy does not help the traders, or it is not a debate on that. What I am trying to do is try to focus on that of the trading rather than the technical analysis, and then you will be able to find how exactly you can do such trades. Now you find that gold and silver, they are just making the final move on the upside. When they have finished it, in the case of euro GBP, they have just formed up and dropped, and in the case of Canadian dollar also they formed up and dropped, but they are not going deeper. CHF, they are making slow gains, and euro GBP, they are making slow drop, and euro yen, they are just, I mean GBP yen, they are making a slow upward move after that. Then also Australian dollar, they just formed up and now dipping it, and yen also, they have just made a dip and then gaining. So you will be able to see what they had done just about 30 minutes back or 1 hour back, and how quickly in the case of gold they have made the gain just to induce all the short sellers to do the short covering. So during such time, when they make quick moves, if you try to sell, you'll be able to, but still keep stop of whatever the stop loss, whatever the loss you will be able to accept, or whatever the loss your equity can bear. And that is very important as far as trading decision is concerned. So they have come all the way to that of 49, and many people are talking about 50. And you find in the case of silver, they come up to that of 49, 49, 10 and things like that, and making very quick dump, the red candle formation. So they quickly make a circular trade and gain the levels and drop the market. So that you need to understand, every market they do it in the similar way. So let me minimize this slide and go into that of the PowerPoint presentation. And also you need to understand another important aspect pertaining to the market. Okay. The market trigger times. The market trigger times are very important for us to understand, because when exactly they are going to bring in the trend reversal, intraday trend reversal, you need to understand. That you will be able to find out from that of the GMT time frame, what they have given it, and with the help of that, if you could follow it. So Bernanke's speech is by 16:30 GMT, and I forgot to change the time here to set it to the GMT. So probably it is shown in red. So at that time they could make some volatile moves. If you are holding already the position, try to close it before that. And when they make a false move, so you know that yesterday when the UK GDP number was to be announced around 8:30 GMT, they made a quick drop before that, and that is an indication that a false move before that of the data release, afterwards they made a big spike. So it is not necessary that you need to know the real data. Based on their moves, you can identify, okay, they make a false move before the data, and afterwards they will make their intentional move. Then they quickly gain the levels in the case of GBP, about 100 at 150 pips. And that is how you can make use of the data release time. And similarly, you come across data release which is displayed in FX Street also. I'll show that. So in FX Street page also, you come across the data release times are also being displayed in GMT time. So that you can make use of. If you click it, you'll be able to see the full calendar and try to note down the times. You can just go through for academic purpose all the data which are to be released, and what is more important for you is the trigger time. So when they make a drop, then before the data, understand they wanted to rise. If they rise before the data, understand that they wanted to drop after the data. Any data for that matter, and you just watch it carefully, and if you find it is a convincing concept, this is the way they trap the traders, you can use such time to take positions in the market. Now I'll go back to that of the PowerPoint presentation. Now we'll go in for the trading decisions. Now in the case of euro, they have come back to that of the middle level, so no trading opportunity when it is in the middle level. Similarly, in the case of GBP, they have come down after making a small drop, probably 16:30 GMT. Before that, they will make an upward move and then try to drop. During that time, you can take a sell position near that of the high, and that will be able to give you the profit. And in the case of yen also, it is below that of the initial low and closer to that of the new low. Small dip, you can take a buy. Small dip in the case of USD CHF, you can take a buy, and a small gain in the case of euro, you can take a buy. It's not necessary that I have to take a position now. I can explain to you, because it has already made the dip. So if I take, then they might hit my stop. Instead, at stop hit level, if I keep a limit, then you'll be able to take it. So for example, I can keep sell order at 1.4863, because they went up to that and came down, and probably they not breached the high 48.77. So they might give a definite fill around the same level with 30 pips stop. So that way, you can keep a limit order. If they fill the limit order, fine. If they don't fill the limit order, it doesn't matter. We are not losing anything. And we can look for the next opportunity because the market continues to give trading opportunity. Similarly, in the case of GBP, we can keep a sell limit order because they went up to 1.680 when I was talking to you and then subsequently made about 20 pips dip. So with the same level, they may come around that in a swing because they failed to breach the high. And during that of the speech time, they could make a small firming up and then start dropping. At that time, we could get a different fill. And then a stop of 30 pips. Similarly, CHF and yen also near that of the low, you can keep. And already I am holding a buy position in the case of Australian dollar, sorry, sell position 1.0961 with a stop at entry, and if they stop me out, I'll just try to take another sell position above that. Then in the case of USD CAD, I took a buy position, it stopped at entry, and they are just trading around that of, okay, they have filled it. It is stopped out. Now, we have come to this. Then probably I'll just wait for about 10 to 30 minutes. If they are not going deeper, then re-enter buy position. So during the close of the session, they showed about 20-30 profit because I explained that during the part one of the webinar, when the spread between the low and the high is very less than that of 50 to 60 pips or 70 pips, then you will find the moves may not be very significant and you may fail to do that book profit. And the same thing happened to me, and somebody asked also that as a spread only 27 pips, why you had taken a buy position CAD. So it has been proved now, I have been stopped out, I just showed the 20 pips, I failed to grab it and they just stopped it out. Then we can re-enter in the market, nothing is lost here, and what the position is taken is not precious for me. As long as it is not incurring any loss, I am willing to close it and try to re-enter in the market if they are not going deeper to that and earn money out of that. So this is how we have to take the entry and exit decision. Then in the case of Euro GBP, I got a position with 50 pips stop. And currently GBP is 89.07, very subdued moves are seen, hardly about 10 pips profit is seen. Euro CHF, a buy position, 1.2891 with 50 pips stop, still there, it is hovering around the same level. Euro CHF is trading around 1.2883, 1.2886, still they are not showing a profit here to keep stop at entry. And slowly when they show profit here, I can keep stop at entry and try to trail the stop upward when they go up. Because it is market is making a consolidation here with a small firming up and small dip and things like that. Now they are handling the Euro GBP cross. You see that Euro is showing 48.54 with the red indication of bid and ask, whereas GBP is showing 66.72, 66.76, which is slightly improved because of that Euro GBP is making small dips. So they are trying to gain the level and dipping, or that is giving to that of the traders when they come for short covering. So this is how they make the moves, and during the trend reversal times, probably it will be really patient testing time. And so, which is also explained here, basically what the position I had taken during that of the European session, still the market is around the same level, not giving any opportunity to book profit on the upside or on the downside. So this is how you come across the situations, and that is why small traders, I suggest not to take positions during the last week of the month and the first week of the month, and in case if you take position, try to book profit very quickly as a swing trade and avoid doing position trade. Once the trend is set, one can take the positions and that will be really helping you. So I'll minimize the PowerPoint presentation and focus the camera over that of the live market quote page. And take up the questions which are asked here. Okay, Kannan, please explain subdued moves with a chart. See, when you find the horizontally, the candles are formed and the spread between that is about 10 to 15 pips for a prolonged period of more than 30 minutes, then it is subdued move. And when can we get the timing other way? Why? They are all recorded. The webinars are recorded. If you go through these webinars, you will be able to find the PowerPoint presentation being displayed. Can make a note of it. You have to do a little bit of homework on your side to learn how to trade in the market. Everything cannot be spoon-fed. And Kannan, after downward stop and should we wait for 2 hours or jump to get in? I explained that there is a difference between the stop and that of the extended move. In a stop and they go below that of the, or they go above that of the high, for example, and come below that in less than 30 minutes. And that is stop and. And they go above that of the high and stay there for more than 30 minutes and continue for 2 hours. And that is extended move. If they continue further up, then it is intentional move. Okay? And that they have to cut the new high again and again. That is the condition. Now the new high, they are not breached. So that means they are simply holding and making consolidation and distributing it. Hope you are able to understand that. Then extended stop and or over yet, extended stop and is a move of about 100 to 150 pips. Very quick upward move and retrace all the levels in a matter of 30 minutes to 1 hour. Still they have not done it. So they could do it during next week before making further drop. Yes. Can we see the initial highs and the lows in the FinWiz? Yeah, when you watch it during 2-3:30 GMT, you will be able to note it. You can note it down from the live market quote page or FinWiz watch or is convenient to you. Then DD. Do you expect Australian dollar come under 1.0? Yeah, they are likely to bring it down slowly. Probably they could use Bernanke's speech as a trigger till such time that they hold and just distribute the positions. If they fail to cut the high, it's very, very unlikely that they will cut the high unless and otherwise it is a breaking news. In Kannan, extended stop ends for AUD is over. They just went up. During that of the European session, around 12 GMT, afterwards they have not cut the high again. Stop and is to go above that of the high. Then, AD, a quick view on Euro for next month. Euro is expected to make the slide next month according to the algorithm. But I have to fine tune it by using the market reading. And that I will be posting it at the blog. Now you know that the blog is being migrated. From that of the WordPress to that of the fxtrade.net. So this is fxtrade.net and there you come across the blog is being posted and if you go to that, once you log in and you'll be able to see that post is being displayed, then if you click blogs, all the blogs will be displayed in sequence and whichever the blog you are interested, you can just click that particular blog and whenever they are updated automatically, they are being refreshed and you come across, they are being displayed and you can go through all the blogs and get different views rather than simply following me. You can listen to others' views also, then make your objective analysis and try to take trading decisions. And that way, you know, you will be able to really develop your zones, your sense of judgment. The sense of judgment is very, very important for anybody for that matter. And if you simply follow somebody, if it goes wrong, then you tend to yell at that particular somebody without understanding that somebody is telling some rubbish, why you accepted it? No? And only if you get convinced and you try to do your own analysis and judgment, then you will be able to handle the trade very carefully and you will be able to also take appropriate decision to exit and or exit out of a loss making position or a exit out of a profit making position with a profit, etc. So rather than simply or blindly following somebody. So you can just read the blog and go through all, but what I suggest is go through other blogs as well. Then you come across, everybody has developed their own concept out of experience and in-depth analysis of the market. It is not something like that they have just developed it and giving it in a fake street. And you know the type of hard work they have done it in order to present in FX Street is enormous. FX Street does not just like that publish anybody's comments, you know, very well. Because of that, they have grown very fast. You should be able to understand that and try to give weightage for that and try to give importance to all the blogs, what has been given, and then evaluate and choose or pick your own favorites and try to use it. And this, if you do it, you will be able to really stand on your own leg. That is very, very important for you to become a successful trader. So now the blog is moved from that of fxtrade.com to that of fxtrade.net. It is a social network. There are certain advantages once the blogs are being updated for that of, for the benefit of the people. It can be linked and the RSS feeds are also available. And you can subscribe for the RSS feed. Automatically you will get the alerts whenever the blog is being updated. And also you can continuously ask questions. And if you just click the blog, you will be able to see the comments. And it's mentioned, 3 comments are there. You can just go through that. Otherwise, you know, sometimes some of the comments much might be deviating from that of the market. You can just avoid going through those comments also. So I take this opportunity to thank everybody who have come here. And also FX Street for the nice provision of the timing. So thank you one and all for your patience here. See you again next time. As usual, Monday I'll come with the Asian session live market analysis. Thank you one and all.